Hello, folks. Tim Walking Bear, the Plant Whisperer here. How y'all doing today? Well, I guess it's time to piss off some Christians. And please let me clarify that it is not my intention to piss people off. It's just my intention to express my personal views on certain matters. But that has a tendency to piss some people off. And an elder once told me that if you're not pissing somebody off, then you're not doing something right. Implying that if you're pissing people off, you are doing something right. Well, anger is very closely related to passion, and passion moves people. Anyway, I wanted to speak a little bit today about Christianity. I see in the news a lot of Christians are up in arms about the Muslim community. It almost seems like there's some sort of a war going on between Muslims and Christians. We know about the wars that have been going on in that regard for thousands of years, but I'm talking more along the lines of a war of words. We have people calling for certain prayers for Obama and his family, and then other Christians saying that's wrong and getting offended. We got Christians calling for the burning of the Quran and all kinds of crazy things. Now, what they hope to accomplish by these things, I don't know. But one thing, if you are a Christian and you're following Christian life, then first and foremost you have to ask yourself, what would Jesus do in this situation? And try to blueprint your life according to that. According to your answer to that, what do you think Jesus would do in any given situation? As a Christian, that's how we are told that we should approach life. Because Christ came, lived on this earth, according to the legends of the Bible, to show us and give us a blueprint for life, a good way to live our life. So through the example of the life of Christ, we have a blueprint to model our own lives after. So, before you go burning a sacred text or criticizing somebody else for praying for somebody in a certain way, you must ask yourself, would Jesus take this action? Would Jesus take this stance? And I don't think he would. Now, a lot of Christians take the word of Jesus very literally. And I find that kind of ludicrous because it's quite clear by the teachings of Christ that he taught in parables. And that it was meant, all of Christ's teachings were meant to be taken metaphorically and not literally. But why are we humans so quick to take things literally when it is to our advantage or to, it is advantageous to our agenda? Then we'll take those words literally. Well, they were meant to be received metaphorically. For instance, the statement that Jesus made, that there is only one way to the Father, and that is through him. What do we think that means? Many Christians mean that things... Blah, blah, blah. Sorry about that. Many Christians seem to believe that that means you must be baptized into a certain church to find eternal life and to get to the Father. Otherwise, you face eternal damnation. I don't think that's accurate myself. Other Christians say that means you have to accept Jesus into your heart as your personal Savior. I think that might be a little closer to what Jesus was really meaning by his statement that there's only one way to the Father, and that's through him. But again, that sometimes gets taken too literal. If we look at things in terms of parables rather than literally, and we set aside the literalness and only focus on parables, then we start to focus on the true meanings or the true lessons within the stories. And I think that's what Christ really wanted us to get. So when he said there's only one way to the Spirit, and that is through him, in my way of looking at things, and this is only my personal opinion, I would say that means accepting the blueprint of his teachings as a blueprint for our own lives and applying that within our hearts and our actions. Because we have to really feel and believe that what we are doing is proper for it to be genuine. And to feel that, it has to be within our hearts, not just in our minds and in our actions, but within our hearts. And I believe that that's what Christ meant when he said there's only one way to the Father, and that is through him. I think what he's saying there is model your life after the meaning of the teachings that Christ gave us in the examples of his life and the parables of the stories that he told us. And I don't really think that has anything to do with what church you might be involved in, or whether you accept the stories of the Bible as historical fact or not. I think all of that is irrelevant. It doesn't matter whether the story of Christ is real or not historically. It doesn't matter what church you choose to attend or be a part of. In fact, I believe that if Christ were here today, he wouldn't join any church. Would he be a Christian? That's an interesting question. Considering he was raised Jewish, I don't know. I think what he's referring to when he speaks about there's only one way to the Father and that is through me is accepting the Spirit of Christ within your heart, which doesn't mean you have to accept the stories and the legends as historical fact. It just means take those teachings, take those parables and apply them in your life and accept them into your heart. I believe this is what he meant by this statement. Too much pointing of the fingers is going on. Everybody's saying, my way is the right way and your way is wrong. You got to follow my way or you're going to hell forever. I don't buy that crap. Because you know what makes me think that that's a bunch of bullshit? The biggest factor that makes me think that? I am an ordained minister. I am a Native American spiritualist. And I have been involved in many ceremonies, many powerful, powerful healing ceremonies. And I have seen people, Christian and non-Christian, people of many spiritual walks of life, come together in one setting, in one ceremony, to pray for a common goal. And the Great Spirit answers those prayers. And I have seen other times when a Buddhist prays for healing on somebody, and they are healed. I have seen times when a Christian prayed for the healing of somebody, and that person was healed. I have seen times when people of many different spiritual walks and religions have prayed and laid hands on somebody to ask for healing, and the God Spirit, the Creator, answered that prayer and healed those people. This tells me that God is not discriminatory against one person who chooses to follow a certain religion or church or be involved in a certain church. God recognizes the intention in our heart, and that's what will motivate the creative spirit to act upon miracles within our lives. It doesn't matter what church you belong to. It doesn't matter what name you choose to call God. It's all one spirit. And God recognizes the intention in your heart, not what church you go to or how much money you put in the plate. God recognizes the intention in your heart. And if you are sincere, then God will answer your prayers. Plain and simple. All these people, the priests, there's preachers down in Florida calling for the burning of the Quran. And other Christians have asked for prayer, made prayer requests for Osama bin Laden and his family. And other Christians get upset about it. Well, my message to you guys are, before you make any statements like that, before you condemn somebody else for their prayer request, before you condemn somebody else's religion and desecrate their sacred items and their sacred text, ask yourself this one question. If you are a true Christian, you must ask yourself this question. What would Jesus do? If I were Jesus in this moment, how would I handle this situation? If I were Jesus, what would he do? This is what God and the Creator and Jesus' Spirit asked you to do when Jesus came and walked on this land and gave us those teachings. Or gave us the legend of that life. He was telling us, model your life after what I am doing. He says, you can do greater deeds than me. So he's all about personal self-empowerment. He's saying that I can lay hands on the dead and raise them. I can walk on water, and you can do this too and more. Personal empowerment. He didn't come here to say, oh, you got to go through a middleman to be empowered, or you got to go through a certain church to be empowered. He came here to say that my spirit lives within you. The creative spirit of the universe lives within your heart. Accept it, work with it, and all things are possible. Pretty basic, pretty simple, pretty straightforward. Let's stop bickering about historical facts, because historical facts, it doesn't matter. It's irrelevant. The relevance is how you live, what you do in life, and how that affects others and the world as a whole. If you are a preacher and you're calling for the burning of the Quran, how is that going to affect your congregation? How is that going to affect Muslim people? How is that going to affect other people in the world? That is the question you must ask yourself before you take action. And would Jesus do this? That's the big question you must ask yourself. Because if you are a Christian, then you're following the teachings of Christ. Therefore, that is a question that must come first and foremost before you take any action in life. Anyway, I know that this is going to be a controversial video and probably stir up some adverse responses, but hey, that's all good. It's just my personal opinion, and who knows, might be completely wrong. Anyway, you guys all have a good day. Duh-ho.